Thank you once again for joining us here at Completing Christ as we continue to walk through the book of Philippians. And man, it's been a pretty neat journey. And I can't tell you how thankful we are for this opportunity and how thankful we are for you and you consistently joining in and walking through the Word of God with us. What a joy and what an honor and what a privilege. You know, we see that Paul wrote this book to the church at Philippi. And man, he's in jail. He's in prison. And he understood that God was using all of that, just like he uses everything that comes into our life, if we will allow him, for his honor and his glory to advance the kingdom and to mold and to make us more like Jesus. You know, and as we have been walking through chapter 3, we begin to see the importance of rejoicing, but we also begin to see that Paul had issued a warning about some false teaching. And last time that we were together, we started talking about verses 7 through 11 and just simply knowing Jesus. And we looked at the fact that Paul just didn't know about Jesus, but that Paul really knew Jesus and Paul lived out this relationship. And I want to continue with that thought as we look at the second part of simply just knowing Jesus. Look with me today in chapter 3, beginning with verse 9. We're going to look at 9 through 11 today. Look at what it says. It says, "And being found in him, and not having a righteousness of my own derived from the law, but that which is through faith in Christ, the righteousness which comes from God on the basis of faith, that I may know him," there it is again, "that I may know him, and the power of his resurrection, the fellowship of his suffering, being conformed to his death, in order that I may obtain the resurrection of the dead." Wow. Made right. I want you to think about that for just a moment with me. You know, Paul was made right through Jesus. Notice what he says here. He says a righteousness that comes from God, based on faith in Jesus, not derived from the law, not one of my own doing, not something I've earned, not based on what I've done, but based on the fact that I placed my faith in what God did for me through the provision of Jesus on the cross. Let's talk just a minute about being made right. It's in Christ alone that we're made right, that we're declared righteous. And the word righteous is simply a word that means to be made right, to be able to stand before the judgment of God and God say, look at me or look at you, as he looked at Paul and says, look, he's washed in the blood of Jesus. He's made right because he's placed his faith in Jesus. I am so thankful today for the power of the blood and the life of Jesus to make someone like me right, that my righteousness is not derived on my own doing. Paul says, look, my righteousness didn't come from the law or my obeying the law. It did not come from my religious activity. It didn't come from anything that I've done. It's a gift from God through the provision of Jesus, and I place my faith in Jesus. Therefore, I have been declared righteous. What about you? What are you counting on to make you right with God, to make you right before God? Is it religious activity? Is it what you've done? Is it based on you and what you're trying to do to gain and earn the favor of God? Listen to me. God has already given us his favor through Jesus. And righteousness only comes through the provision of Jesus in Christ alone, and placing our faith in the finished work of what he did for us on the cross, in the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus. We are declared to be right before God. Thank God for a righteousness that is given to us as a gift through the provision of Jesus. And the second thing I want you to think about today is, let's go back to that know him or knowing him. He talks about that again in the second half of this passage. He says in verse 10 that I may know him, and I may know the power of his resurrection. I may know the fellowship of his suffering, being conformed to his death, in order that I may obtain the resurrection from the dead. Paul says that I know him. that I may know him. Now, remember, as we talked about last time, not just knowing about Jesus, but really knowing Jesus, living out a relationship with Jesus. Remember that salvation is knowing Jesus. Christianity is Christ. It's not works. It's not rules. It's not regulations. It's not religion. It's a relationship. And he says that I may know the power of his resurrection. The word power there comes from the Greek word dunamis, which is a word that we get the word dynamite from. It's that achieving power of God, that capable power of God. He is able. He says here that I may know the power of his resurrection. The resurrection comes from a word that means to be brought back to life, to be moved from death to life. Just like Jesus came out of that tomb in victory over death and over sin, that he was dead, but that God raised him from the dead. The same thing happens to me and you when we say yes to Jesus, is we move from spiritual death to spiritual life, that we've been given new life in this relationship with Jesus. Praise God for the power of the resurrection. May we understand and know the power, the capable power of God in and through our lives to move us from being spiritually dead to being spiritually alive. And then he says, I may know the fellowship of his suffering. We talked several times through this series about the word fellowship, the Greek word koinonia. And it's much, much more than shaking a hand, a hug in the neck, but it's that partnering with, that participation, that doing life with. Here he says to know the fellowship of his suffering, of his affliction. Life for Jesus was hard. You know, he went through a lot. He was persecuted. He suffered. He gave his life for us. And we have the privilege to partner in the suffering and the afflictions of Jesus. That for us as believers, life is not going to always be easy. But thank God for the privilege that we have, empowered by the Spirit, to fellowship in the suffering and the affliction for the cause of Christ. Man, Lord, give me a heart to take up my cross daily. Because remember, taking up a cross is never easy. It's never comfortable. Lord, give me a heart to take up the cross, to deny myself, and to simply follow Jesus. And then he says, being conformed to his death, in order that I may obtain the resurrection from the dead. Being conformed, that word conformed means to make of like form. As I read that last phrase in verse 10 and verse 11, I thought about Galatians 2:20, which I think helps us better understand this. Galatians 2:20 says, I have been crucified with Christ. You see, when we come to Jesus, we die. It's as if we transcended in time and that we were on the cross and we died when we said yes to Jesus. I have been crucified with Christ. But it's no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. Thank God for the power of the Holy Spirit that lives within us, that Jesus himself, through the person of the Holy Spirit, living in us to empower us to live out the Christian life. I've been crucified with Christ. It's no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. And now the life I now live in the flesh, in this fleshly body, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself up for me. I trust him with my life. I trust him, the finished work of Jesus, the death, the burial, the resurrection of Jesus for my salvation. And I trust that same Jesus and the work of Jesus with my life, that I trust him. I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself up for me. You know, as I close out today, man, I'm just reminded that yes, there will be a future resurrection. But praise God that through Jesus, that I've been raised to walk in the newness of life and to live like I've never lived before. Why? Because I know Jesus. You see, in knowing Jesus, we've been moved from death to life, to live in the newness of life, to fellowship in his suffering, to understand that we've been resurrected, that we've been moved from death to life. And that this relationship with Jesus, just knowing Jesus, changes everything. Man, I pray that we'll live like we really, really know Jesus. Not just know about him, but that we know him. And may we live empowered by his presence in our life. Thank you, God, for what you did in the life of Paul. And thank you for leading him by your Spirit to write this to us so we can understand the importance of knowing Jesus and the transforming power of the cross in a person's life. May we be conformed to be more like Jesus than we ever thought this side of eternity through this relationship with Jesus. I encourage you today, go let Jesus be Jesus in and through your life. Have a blessed day. Thank you.